You die easily for a god!
I am nobody. Nobody. But when the son of Ra stands on the mountain and says, do it, it gets done.
Next, you told them to murder!
I am not sorry. Is Baya Kastiwa sorry? I lost my family. You lost your family. We have the right to do anything we want to anyone!
No! We are different! You burnt farms! You killed innocents! You're insane!
Hypocrite! Yeah! You can pile up 1,000 dead bodies in front of me. It doesn't change me. The world will burn! The Order won't save it! You will burn with it, Magi.
May you walk the land of the Duat!
Dead. I should tell Zahra.
Hey now! You're finished! I see you!
Not going
to wait a minute.
Ha! You're dead.
Thank you.
Stop right there!
Son of Ra is dead. It was disturbing. His madness almost made sense.
If you stare deeply enough into any madness, there is a logic.
So what now? The fires are stopped. Your farms are safe.
I don't know. I am hungry, though. Now we return to the farm to feast in peace.
Is that an invitation?
You are the Magi. You figure it out. My gate is open and my fruit is sweet.
That is Horus, the Falcon, the Great Black One, God of the sky. The sun is his right eye, and the moon is his left eye. Forever he flies across the heavens, making night and day. Those are the scales, called Khonsu. When we die, the goddess Ma'at weighs our hearts on them, against her white feather.
I remember this. If our hearts appear in light, we walk in the field of reeds.
Very good. You were listening. The scales measure truth and justice, which is why Magi pursue these two things above all others.
retransmission, segment 4. Requiring a temporary aid. It has been 99 days since the great catastrophe. The messenger speaks.
On the 21st day of December 2012, Desmond activated the global Aurora Borealis device and protected the Earth from the sun's deadly coronal mass ejection. On the 21st day of December 2012, humanity carried on without a care in the world. People went to work, people went to school, and people went to the well for water. On the night of December 21st, 2012, as the sun set on their days, humankind went to bed. Then on the morning of December 22nd, 2012, humankind was graced with yet another morning. They never knew that on the previous day, the world almost ended. We thought that would have been enough. And it was, until it wasn't. Time is unyielding. It always corrects itself. The language of time works in many ways, two of which you can understand, as you are now. Linear continuity is a simulation that allows for variations. Within the linear continuity, there are nodes, choke points, moments where algorithms converge the flows of superposed possibilities to a single moment, where only one absolute truth is possible. Paths are fluid. Continuous. Nodes are static. Changeless. And the wave function collapses the paths into nodes which branch out, again and again. And again. And so I wonder, can you feel the wave collapsing, trying to course correct Desmond's act of defiance? The incoming node needs the world to end. The algorithms have been carving the flow of possibilities towards that end for over 100 years now. A labyrinth of trenches, filled with mud and mustard gas. Families cowering in fear as V2s vaporize their dwellings. Fire born from the bellows of the Los Alamos laboratory, fueling global catastrophes. The Serpukhov 15 incident of 1983. The Doomsday Clock, tucked away in an office at the University of Chicago, its needle moving as the years go. The node is near. Perhaps you knew. Perhaps you felt it too. That the world is closing in on you.
Excuse me, I'm looking for a man named Bayek. I'm here to give you passage.
In blackest night, the Sinai sleeps, exhausted with grief. Our mouths filled with ashes, we weep tears of blood. Who will deliver us from despair? Our hero moves with the mist, as silent as the sea, delivering death. Unknown, unseen, ever unforgiving. Listen. Let me tell you of him. The legend of Siwa. The shadow who is Bayek. Bayek, Bayek, Bayek.
Sounds like quite a man. I need to find the hideout. It should be visible from a height. The entrance is closed. There must be another way in. Bureau.
My name is Kashta. It is an honor to meet you, Mentor.
No formalities, Kashta. We are both equally hidden ones.
Such loss of life.
Tahira,
Bayek, thank the gods you have come.
Your message was urgent.
These are the swords of two hidden ones I recruited, killed in a massacre.
They will be remembered as martyrs to the cause.
This is Gamilat, leader of the Nabatean rebels.
What happened?
We retreated through the village. The Romans pursued us in a fury and took their anger out on the villagers.
It was pure butchery. Innocent men and women. The Hidden Ones tried to stop it and were killed.
They understood the risks.
I assigned them to help the rebels.
Tahira. What has been done cannot be undone. The Hidden Ones have no place in battles, but we can help the rebellion by eliminating the Roman leader.
General Rufio. But he is in Rome.
Rufio has three lieutenants here in the Sinai.
These three men will die.
Let's get to it.
I am indebted to you.
We do this for the people, Gamilat.
Yes, the people. The people and I are one and the same.
Sokon has been missing for 2 weeks. He is the Shadow tasked with surveying the quarry.
Yet the Shadow became lost.
It may be too late for Sokon. He went to a merchant ship at the dock several days ago, and that place is crawling with Romans. It would be a shame to lose him. His passion for the people and the Hidden Ones knew no bounds. I would die for him.
I will find this Sokon. I should go meet Tahira above the quarry.
Tahira! Oh no, leave me alone! I didn't do anything!
Quiet down, boy. Be calm. Why are you saying such things?
There are bounty hunters looking for a man with an eagle. I will receive gold if I tell them.
What bounty hunters?
They call themselves the Shadows of the Scarab.
The Scarab? Nek, little boy, I'm not the man you are looking for. That is no eagle. It is a pigeon.
This is a very brave pigeon. Wait, are you lying? I'm telling the bounty hunters!
I should find these Shadows of the Scarab.
Bayek, it is time to dispose of Rufio's lieutenant. Tacito often comes out to roost atop the quarry. He is a brutal overseer. He makes an example of his workers every day. I will stay close by and get a view of this worker. But are you sure it is wise to kill him in the open?
Tahira, this sends a message. The Hidden Ones will not settle for any oppressor.
To kill him in front of his army, or the workers will cause riot.